Hi.
This is Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
The aftermath of every social revolution brings about change. Cultural norms shift as our minds and hearts expand beyond the familiar. To everything, there is a season and a time to every purpose in the land of the living. This is our time to renew, revive, and restore the hope lost to the busyness of life. This is our time to dig again and rebuild from the storms of our past on a solid footing that holds. Welcome to The Foundation.
The Foundation. Foundation.
The foundation of Hard Grants is brought to you by Alive, Bahamas Welding and Fire, Burger King, Commonwealth Bank, the Digital Transformation Unit, and Marco's Pizza.
The Foundation. The Foundation.
That's rocking the nation. Howard Grant's the host, Guardian Radio Station 96.9. 12 to 2 is the time. You can call the show or use the text line. Yeah, he educates, he informs. He goes against the norm. He's really got that zeal. Plus, he's a child of God.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. 96.9 FM radio, Howard Grant in your company, live and in full effect today. Talk to me. I am here in the flesh. 9 FM, guys. So happy to be in your company here in the land of the living, really being able to chomp it down. I was not with you yesterday. Forgive me. Forgive me, please. I know that you always need me like your proverbial shot of espresso to kind of be able to juice up your day and get you going. I know. I ain't gonna fight you. But I was unable to make it yesterday due to some issues I didn't rectify yesterday. Still going on, but I said, let me kind of get in here and make these things happen. So grateful for you to be able to have patience with me. And I'm hoping that you enjoyed that show that we did back in February. Well, today, guys, is May 23rd, Tuesday, May 23rd. So happy to be in your company today and really being able to chop it down. We're going to take a different course today. And, you know, normally we have our collective panel conversation on Wednesdays. Tomorrow, we're going to be able to bring Cassius in. So Cassius is kind of exciting to talk about. But today, my good friends, man, I'm telling you the truth. I did this. I've done this, over the and continue to be able to, you know, re-engage this person who's here in the studio with me. And you heard him enough. I had a couple of texts that says to me, Howard, you got to bring this guy back. Howard, you got to bring him back. I like how he's taking. I like how he's talking. Well, then the studio with me is none other than Garth Rosborough. He's here with me to talk about some things. We're going to be talking about politics. We're going to be talking about this charged political environment. We're going to be talking about this concept of the Bahamas for Bahamians being a farce. And make sure you pick up your newspapers to be able to read and see exactly what's going on in there. It says the NASA. Well, make sure you pick up the Nassau Guardian. It says diesel sales stop at some station. Petroleum retailers start action and push for margin increase. My goodness, this is crazy. In the studio with me is none other. Also joining Garth with us is none other than Bishop Kerman Agaro-Hinzi. He's here with us being able to chomp these things down. A former bus driver himself that can be able to speak to the necessity of being able to ensure that we have fuel for the communication and make a couple of dollars here on this street. Guys, the lines are going to be open today. I want you to be a part of the conversation. 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259. Anywhere from the family of islands, 242-300-5720, 242-300-5720. That's also, watch me, also a toll-free call. Please don't call me cussing or man how it is on the phone for 38 minutes. Call 300-5720. so we can be able to get you in there at no cost to you. 422-4796 is our text line, and we want you to be a part of that on the text line so we can be able to make some things happen. Guys, it's a beautiful day. Hold up. Wait. Before we go anywhere. Hold on. Where is my text line? Wild. It's not here. Okay. CA, did you steal the text line? You need to stop. Bring it back. Let's make these things happen. Guys, it's a beautiful day, and we're going to be able to chop it down. It is always great. A wonderful thing to be here in the studio with you today. Now, I want to start it off in decency and order. I want to do that. We're going to tie all these things in today. But over the past 2 weeks and some, we've seen a significantly charged political environment, which is absolutely baffling to me. Friday, we actually, kind of ended the show on this conversation about Arinthia Kumalafe and some of the pictures that we saw in the papers with her last week. A call was made to me right after, right? And, how would we support Arinthia? She is our leader. And wherever she go, I'm going. Okay, I'm not going to fight you. I'm not going to fight you, baby. But talk to me. You can't talk for your leader. Your leader got to come talk to me. I mean, let's just shoot straight. We need to have a very clear understanding. You know why? Because it ain't like we're trying to get in your business. The country is trying to identify the next dispensation of leaders in this for the general election coming up. The country is trying to identify the quality character, and we will watch you from now, whether or not you remain consistent in what you say that you're going to do, and if we should lend our support to you in that go-round. So we would like to hear from the horse's mouth the position that they've taken. I want to be able to, again, extend an opportunity for Ms. Arinthia Kumalafe to be able to sit with me. I know my girl listening to me. She didn't call me. You know you can't call me on the radio, baby. Call the number 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259. Call that. When this light up, I want to ask you about those particular things. I just need to know. We need to know whether or not there is stickability. There is this sort of determination to make things happen. We need to make a determination as to whether or not we should rally behind Arinthia at this go-round. Garth, my brother, what do you make of what's been going on from a political standpoint over the past few weeks?
I do believe that with everything that's going on internationally, it has brought much pressure to the national conversation here in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas. Good day to everyone. Good day to my fellow Bahamians, my listeners, Ms. Ebron Smith in Atlanta, etc. It's good to have you all with us. Looking at the amount of homicides that we're having in our country, looking at the migration issues, looking at the increase in cost of food, right now it's not a very easy time for Bahamians. We're looking for solutions. We know very clearly what the problems are, what we have not been able to be successful with in the past decade or more is an entity that actually can bring to this country the type of answers necessary to propel us.
You mean political entity?
Yes, sir.
Talk to me.
To propel us to where this nation could potentially be. We've been sidelined with talks of corruption. We've been sidelined with the whole idea of the pandemic and Dorian and everything else that has been totally an obstruction to where we would ideally want to be. I do believe in the first 10 years of our independence, and I say independence in quote, our country was on a very good track. It wasn't easy, but we were making the progress that was necessary for, and excuse me for saying this, but a colonized nation that's now become free to move forward into true independence. Lately, in the last 20 years, it's just been confusing. We've gone from PLP to FNM, PLP to FNM. We've had the DNA come. I asked someone yesterday the question, where has the DNA gone? It seems as if the same Arinthia Kumalafe, when she left, the DNA died. They may still be in existence. I don't know if Mr. Nesbitt still is the leader of that party, but I've not heard anything from them. In the last election, we have had a copious amount of political entities involved. We've had the Cassius Stewarts, the Ali McIntoshes, the Micklin Seymours, the Wesley Campbells, the Garth Rose Burroughs, and more, which was very confusing, and everyone is saying that they have the answers. And so what the people did is that we reverted back to the PLP, which we can say now is really the mother party or the father party of this nation, and we were hoping for at least some stability now to say, let's move forward. If you recall, the PLP came on the political scene after winning the election with Vision 2040. Remember that. And everyone says, you know what? Oh, this is an old vision, but you know what? It is possible. Right now, today, we're still asking the question, where is Vision 2040?
Is it wrapped in the National Development Plan?
No one has seen the evidence of it because when people are in pain, they're oblivious to whatever attempt you're making because you're not taking care of their immediate situation, which is one where they've been stimulated to feel something that they do not want to experience, which is pain. Pain is economic in this country. I'm happy to see the health situations are going to, reconstruct the clinics in Andros and Eleuthera. They're building a health clinic over in Grand Bahama. They're going to rebuild the airport. Yes, you're going to do these things, but right now, let's talk about the now. Right now, the people are hurting and looking for answers.
You know, you speak as though that there is the two major political organizations, who you call the mother or the father party, what we call the grandfather political party in this country. Talk to me.
Yes.
Just be very clear.
Rami and Papi.
Right? This is the grandfather political. They hold the tradition of what political parties look like in this country.
Correct.
Now, since then, we've seen the PNC, the BDM, the DNA, the COI, and so many others pop up. I can't even remember. In the last 2 days before election, at least 58 come up. What people do it, right?
At least 10.
So let's be very clear about it. And then we have to use this in quotation, the Progressive Party, and because that's what it is.
Okay.
I don't think that the PLP, though their name is wrapped, the Progressive is wrapped in their name, they are the grandfather party in this country.
They are.
And we've seen them take significant progressive steps over the years.
Yes.
But in this era, in this dispensation right now, I don't know whether or not we can be able to call them the Progressive Party. The COIs, right? The DNAs, in terms of their language to identify new industries, to identify new paths and opportunities for economic empowerment for the people. These are where the progression exists at this time. Every single time, they're shut out. Let's just be very clear about this. Every single time, they're shut out. Okay?
That's correct.
To the point where the former Prime Minister Ingram would take on a position to say that, if I don't get it, you can get it.
That's correct.
Let's talk about this.
That's correct.
Let's talk about this.
It happens because whenever the new parties are entering into this fight, it's almost as if God himself has given a vision to move the country forward. Now, don't take this lightly, because there are members of Parliament presently in the PLP and FNM who may also have this very same vision mind. However, because of leadership says what you can and what you cannot do. This is why I always say to people, we're living in a very subtle dictatorship.
Okay.
You have to walk the line.
You did that well, because I was just about to tell you.
I'm your friend. This is, I gotta talk about it.
You did that well. You did that well, because I don't want to identify this as leadership. This is relentless suppression. This is pronounced dictatorship,
not necessarily
the leadership that we've known. Have we ever really known an era? I haven't been born. I wasn't alive for an era that I could be able to say, I remember. That's why I go look for the older fellas. That's why I sit at their feet, because they can truly remember a time where there was true leadership in this country. I said, I think it was last week, we had, we were just, shooting the breeze on the show and being able to talk about the fact that I cannot remember over the past 3 election cycles. If you did not win, I don't even know who you are. That's one.
Correct.
And two, even if you win, if you wasn't a significant player identified by your political organization,
correct,
I still don't know who you is.
And many of them, we still don't know.
I don't know who. If I bump into you and walk on your foot, sorry, sir, sorry, ma'am, I don't know who
that
you are.
That is correct.
Not in a bad way.
That is correct.
I just don't know who you are.
That's correct.
Because they've made no significant contribution to this country. Let's be very, I get in somewhere with this. I'm trying to craft this narrative, and I wean in from what you say. The overarching concept of what I've gleaned from what you said is that the Free National Movement and the Progressive Liberal Party has been the party to be able to move in a particular direction for the country. Now, if you look in the business section for today, Guys, make sure you pick up your Guardian newspaper. You look at the business section for today, the F&M blast corporate income tax green paper and the government response. Now, Pintard says that the David's administration did not follow parliamentary conventions on the matter of such policy importance. And then the Office of the Prime Minister released a statement and said Pintard's statement showed disconnect between current position and actions taken during his time in government. Absolutely correct. Nobody incorrect here. Nobody's incorrect here. But has this perpetual cycle led us to this position where it is time for us to identify them for what they are and reject both of them? Talk to me.
The Bahamian people to this point have shown that they're not clearly interested overwhelmingly with either of the two parties.
No, however, stick a pin there. Stick a pin right there. If the Bahamian people have shown that, why? Because the Free National Movement understands the political landscape, at least they did very well, under the leadership of former Prime Minister Hubert Ingraham. I believe that they still have those elements that exist. Though the eras and times have shifted and different leaders has taken over this, we still have those people within the organization that can be able to say, well, this is the course that we should take. If the Free National Movement knows the landscape so well, why is there such a charged political environment now? Why? Why is the Free National Movement seeking to be able to have small rallies to get their people excited 3 years before an election? Why is the Free National Movement identifying qualified, capable, articulate, and passionate people who has the power and the desire to serve in this country and pushing them out prematurely in preparation for an inevitable political death? That's all this is. This is going to be an assassination politically if you put the woman out 3 years before it's time. That's how I feel about this. And as I look at this, I don't understand. You see, you're all older than me. You all been around. You're all older than me.
I
just need to understand what's the move here.
First of all, I've had the opportunity to work with Ms. Arinthia Komolafi. She has huge potential in terms of her ability to think and push ideas.
I agree.
However, like all of us, including myself, there's still room for growth. There's still room for maturity, especially when you're dealing with the game of politics. Politics is not a regular high school electoral process. We're dealing with demons of the nature of international significance, okay? People who know how to wheel and deal and make deals with the darkest of them all, going into Haiti and coming out like a saint, but they know they've done every sin in the book, including Voodoo
Nobel. This is wild what you're saying, okay? Sir.
Allegedly.
We have to go back to this allegedly.
Excuse me.
Allegedly.
You be the host. You in charge. I say legend.
Okay, let's go.
I want to show them.
You can't push the people in.
Okay. You know about the washing down and the washing up.
I don't know nothing about this.
But listen. And it causes people who have any child of God within their heart to say, I may be out of my league. But for her, she has that ambition. She also has a passion for leadership. But she has to also understand, and I don't want to say this in a very vile way, but this is what leaders do. Michael Pintard has to utilize individuals who have notoriety, those who have passion, those who have the ability to articulate, to put forth plans and ideas in order to prevent the onslaught, I'm going to say it loudly, of a potential Hubert Alexander Minnis taking the throne.
Let me fix it. Michael Pintard have to use who we can, just the way that Minnis used who we can with Renwood Wells and Andre Rollins to insulate himself. Correct. And retain the position of leadership. Let's just be shoot straight.
When I was shooting straight, but okay. I was trying to use the King's English.
Words. I like that.
Well, it's the King's English.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like
that. Because your listeners say I sound smart, so I got to continue sounding
okay,
smart.
Okay, go ahead. You sound smart with me. I enjoy it.
As for her and what I would do, because we all know of her history, whether it's accurate or not, we always felt that she came from the PLP to the DNA, back to the PLP, and now she's seeming to walk across the River Jordan to the F&M. Michael Pintard will continue to find those people, as you said, who can insulate him from any external threat or external, and he should, by all means. That's what leaders do. He has to.
You cannot use a bishop. This is a pawn's game right now.
But the bishop can always use the pawn.
Of course.
You're playing chess.
Now watch me. Why would you use such a significant player at the forefront of the game. The game ain't even really started yet. This the third move on the board.
Maybe he sees the checkmate ahead.
Oh my God. I see. You see what you're doing there. Do you see the checkmate ahead, sir?
There's a very high potential that a checkmate is awaiting. Based on all of the news that we're hearing, like all these social media is very dangerous in this country because Bahamians love gossip. You're hearing all this talk about corruption, who taking the contract money and paying themselves, and et cetera, et cetera. And so Pintard sees an opportunity now to utilize every asset that he could in order to put himself as an emperor on a throne. You cannot wrong him for that. I have my personal issues with Michael Pintard. He may not remember me, but I remember him oh so clearly. I'm going to say this, I'm going to say this to Michael Pintard so he could hear what I'm saying to you. You have to be very careful when you meet a Bahamian citizen on the road and how you treat them, because you don't know who you're speaking to. Every Bahamian citizen in this country has the ability to sink your entire life. That one person in the straw market, who's a straw vendor.
Politically.
They're not a white-collar worker. They're not in the inner circle of the lodge or your church or your political party. But they know everybody in the straw market, and everybody in the straw market knows them and respects them. And you spit on that person, you will pay for that in this country.
Proverbially spit.
So I'll say it very clearly. Michael Pintard, you are extremely arrogant. Mm-hmm. You have to show as a leader some humility. Even if you don't care for an individual, make it look like you do. If you got to be a Judas, you may get hang eventually. That's fine. But be the best Judas you could be. Give them 30 pieces of silver if you have to. But guess what? You are a national leader, and a national leader doesn't care for everybody.
Judas was the recipient of the silver, sir. He didn't distribute
this
silver.
This is a new Judas time.
Oh, Judas don't distribute silver.
Well, listen, let me tell you what they
do. You receive it.
The MP will give you the chicken, the bear, the pork, and everything during the election, eh? And for the next 5 years, tell me what he getting. Steak, filet mignon, huh? Caviar, huh? A Dom Perignon, huh? So what has he done? He will give you 30 pieces of silver because he's going to get $3 million back.
Okay, I see what you did there. You pull it together. Guys, please give me a call, 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259, anywhere from the family of islands, or a toll-free call, please, 242-300-5720, or hit me up on the text, 422-4796. Let me take this telephone call. Caller, you on the line with us. Go ahead, caller. You're gone. Let me see if I can read one or two of these texts. It says, Howard, political prostitute is good on people. Just want to get elected, but coming with no progressive ideas. Mm-hmm. What have the FNM changed? Why Komunafe like the FNM? What can Komunafe bring to the FNM table? If she didn't join just before the last election, she have no political power now. Is the FNM desperate again just to win? This is a question mark.
Can I respond to that?
Of good questions. Go ahead.
The fact is that Arinthi Komolafe, Madam Arinthi Komolafe, she likes to be called Madam at times, did run in the constituency of Carmichael. We all know the former deputy prime minister of this country, the Honorable Desmond Bannister, the former Honorable Desmond Bannister, was the member of parliament for Carmichael. We all know that Mr. Bannister is on the verge of retirement politically, if he has not done so already. So what she has done, like all Bahamians would do, or most Bahamians would do, she sees an opportunity. Because right now, the Honorable Keith Bell is now the Member of Parliament for Carmichael. So if she remains in the Progressive Liberal Party, there's not going to be any room for her in Carmichael, because as we are now looking at Mr. Bell, he's not going anywhere. And if she's already put in the groundwork for Carmichael, her ambition at this time would be to seize an opportunity with a major political party to insert herself to run in the very same constituency that she
did. I don't know if I like this scenario.
You don't have to like it. It is what it is.
It don't make sense.
But guess what? It makes a lot of sense to her because the opportunity is available for her as an FNM. It's not available for her as a PLP.
But that don't make no sense.
Tell me why.
Let me tell you why. Her roots exist within the PLP, an organization that would embrace her and empower her, embolden her, and provide her opportunities to gain the experience both locally and internationally.
She's getting it now. Wasn't she appointed in the Bank of the Bahamas or somewhere like that?
This is what I thought.
This is what I heard.
But I don't have no clarity on that, whether or not this has been a detachment.
It's so alleged. Let's use the word alleged.
This is alleged. The allegations, right? Okay, the social allegations that popped out there. We can easily find that out. I can make two calls, right? Now, the fact of the matter is that the PLP will provide her opportunities to be able to be an ambassador, to go around the world, to get her diplomatic understanding, to get her diplomatic feet wet and understand how to articulate and posture herself in preparation for this leadership that she aspires towards. Because all she's been doing is giving us a great deal of local leadership and theories, right? Theoretically being able to spur, this is what we will do, this is what I would do, this is what we will do, so forth and so on. But the PLP can provide her now, today. The PLP like to talk about Loretta Butler Turner, about her, you remember former Prime Minister Christie would say, well, I don't know why you're over there, you should be here. This is what he said to Loretta Butler Turner, right? And the PLP likes to be able to boast about a great deal of talent that exists out there and how big and wide the tent is in the PLP.
It is wide.
They will provide her an opportunity.
It is wide.
They're giving people an opportunity that make me scratch my head and say,
yeah, because we ain't getting none. It ain't wide enough for me.
Why are you getting me in this? How am I getting this? I'm in this. I sitting over here in neutral space.
I laid on my trickle down.
So for me, because she has this sort of allegiance to the organization, because her proverbial navel string is buried within the organization, mm-hmm. and the organization is eager to identify talent and provide them opportunities to move forward. See, I don't know whether or not she's even a threat to the PLP. She's not a threat to the organization.
But you see,
is a threat to the FNM, though. Let's be very clear. She is a threat going into the organization. She come there for leadership. She ain't come there to play.
Well, I agree. I was waiting to say that, but go ahead. You're on the right track.
She ain't come there to play.
You're on the right track.
She knows when she goes within the organization to the PRP, the mammoth gods that stand.
Oh, praise
listen,
God.
These mammoth gods.
You're preaching.
They stand like pillars in the organization. Yes, you can't get past here, baby, unless we tell you get by. She knows that.
But you have a Glennis Hannah Martin. You ain't getting past her.
Glennis ain't going to let you go nowhere, but Glennis is also in the front of the gods. She ain't going nowhere either.
Thank you very much.
Okay, now let's be very clear about this.
Well, this is a sweet conversation.
But in the free national movement, where the pillars have a crack that run from
room for plenty and more. Yes, sir.
Listen to me.
Preach.
You could see the crack that run through the bell course. You could see it in the organization.
Man, let me see if I got some money for offering in my pocket.
You could see it. Right? I didn't even take a commercial break, and I got to take a commercial break. You could see the crack that run through the organization. And any political astute person would be able to play their cards right, get in the organization, and show themselves worthy of leadership and take the thing. You're joking.
This is the conversation.
This is wild. What are you doing, Michael Pintar? She come for your job.
That's what she's doing. Right.
She come for your job, and you don't see this. See, Arinthia, I didn't want to get in your business. I wanted to talk to you.
Roseboro caused that.
Roseboro caused this, right? Yeah. Let me take a commercial break. I see a telephone call on the line, guys. Please be a part of the conversation. 96.9 FM Radio, Howard Grant, the foundation. We're going to take this quick commercial break. I hope we give you a little jolt. We give you your little political espresso to be able to have a good conversation. We're going to be back right after this.
The foundation.
Get ready, Bahamas. The Bahamas Football Association and the Ministry of Education proud to present Samuel P. Haven Jr. High School Soccer Nationals. May 19th to 27th, witness the best high school soccer action at the Roscoe ALDB Soccer Fields, featuring top senior girls and boys teams from across our islands in the first national soccer championship in 3 years. Catch the R. and Billy Paces, St. Andrews Hurricanes, Patrick J. Bethel, Mighty Mollis, and many more as they compete for the ultimate prize. Don't miss this exciting event. Bring your friends and family to cheer on and support our talented young athletes, the future of Bahamian soccer. More info at BahamasFA.net. See you there.
Ready to step into the future? From your front door to the backyard and everywhere in between. See and speak to whoever's there with Ring Video doorbells and security cameras now available at Alive. Protect what matters most, all from one easy app. Available in your Google or Apple Play Store. Visit bealive.com/ring to learn more. We are Alive.
tired of paying too many bills and loan payments each month?
Shrink your monthly debt payments down to one easy payment with our debt consolidation loan.
It also has a built-in savings that pays you 5% interest.
Inquire about our debt consolidation loans today.
Call 356-7764.
A new appliance, building a new home, or renovating, or just spring cleaning. Bundle and save, or make it a combo with BWF pre-inventory, warehouse clearance, and tent sale. Friday, May 26th through Saturday, May 27th from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. Save big on appliance combo specials, houseware supplies, bedding, curtains and bathroom supplies, kitchen and outdoor, cooking supplies, barbecue grills, selected welding and hardware supplies, generators and pressure washers, automotive supplies and accessories, and a whole lot more. Don't miss it. BWF, we're more than just our name. Number 13 Wilton Street. Call 394-0004-6. Check us out on Facebook. We also ship to the Family Islands.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Foundation. The foundation. The foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM Radio. Howard Grant and your company, The Foundation, on this absolutely gorgeous Tuesday afternoon. So happy to be in your company. We're just chopping a few things down. I'm, you know, it's peculiar looking at the political landscape of how things are happening in the country. And I just wanted to be able to kind of put one or two things on the table and talk about it. And the studio with me is none other than my very good friend, Garth Roseboro, joined by Bishop Kermit Agaro Hensey. Here in the studio with us, being able to talk. Now, Bishop, you've been very quiet. You don't want to talk about these things. Talk to me. Pull the mic close to your mouth. We can put you in it right now. You didn't say nothing. I see your eyebrow going up a couple times. Well, but you didn't say nothing. Well, talk to me.
You sit back and observe. And when you inject yourself in the political arena, you know, you go into organizations and you sit down and you monitor. And when you monitor, you find out the structure of the organization and the ideology of the organization. And I hear a lot of people talk about Kamala Afi. I sit in, I have a few meetings with her at the headquarters at Robinson Road.
So you said indirectly you were a part of the DNA?
Basically.
You were, or you are you currently?
No, I'm not currently.
Okay, talk to me.
And basically what I saw was her husband basically is backing her in that artillery. And my ideology is that you put her in high position, you're putting her husband in high position.
This is heavy what you're saying, sir.
Most definitely.
Allegedly.
Allegedly.
Okay.
Because basically, when you were in the meeting, he was basically the sergeant of arm watching who's
this
coming
in. This is heavy,
in.
Sir?
Yeah, his eyes are dilling from side to side, and he feels like he's threatened. If you come in there with
you
a power,
serious,
yeah.
Sir?
If you come in there and you talk with strength, or you talk with, you know, that knowledge that you understand principles that they apply in, and then that will, you know, become a problem for him, and they will more push you to side.
You cause my throat get dry. 3-2-3-6-2-3-2-3-2-5-4-3-1-6-3-2-5-4-2-5-9. Anybody from the Family Violence 242-300-5720, or you know the text 422-4796.
Listening to the good bishop though.
You can let me take the telephone call.
Take the call.
Let me take the call. Calling you on the line with us live. Go ahead.
My pleasure. Good afternoon. How are you doing, Mr. Grant?
Good afternoon, my brother. What's happening with you?
My days, because you lose the trend of thought and everything.
Go ahead.
But yesterday's show, was that pre-recorded?
Yes, that was a pre-recorded show yesterday.
Oh, I was wondering why you wasn't giving nobody the answer.
Oh, no, I wasn't. I was pre-recorded.
I didn't get the news that it was pre-recorded.
Yeah, they should have dropped the thing. It was from Valentine's
Day. Yeah, but it seems like when you get involved with the religious comment, you don't let nobody call in anyway. You seem to be forcing your Christianity on people.
I am not forcing nothing on nobody.
You believe in one thing. The professor name and everything who was talking about the Constitution and everything according to what Jesus say and everything like that. And you're used to think what Jesus said. You have seen a book written by Jesus.
Sparky, you can just hit me with the controversy or you can hit me with some questions.
Okay, let me get back to what y'all talking about today.
Go ahead.
Because y'all just get off track. Let me tell you something, but I think I'm much older than you've been around long enough. We have seen the political gain in the Bahamas.
Yes.
From the time the PLP came into power. We've seen the up and down between the PLPs and the up and the FNNs. And I think most of us at our age, we've seen the game played out over and over. And like they used to say, I mean, what was it? I think it's the Wilson guy, Andrew Wilson,
mm-hmm.
who used to make the comment, two sides of the same coin. You remember that comment?
As the chairman of the DNA.
Yeah, two sides of the same coin. We've seen it. We've tried our best to vote this one in, to vote that one out. To vote this one in, to vote that one out. And nothing changes. They come around your home. They got a strategy as to when they can start campaigning and coming around your home to beg you for the vote to go down the Bay Street to represent you. And from time immemorial, as soon as you give them the X and they win, when they reach down there, they change them out. They go down to represent the Queen. Or they go down to represent the King now. One minute there's a QC, now there's a KC. And it's the same people from the same parties. And when they move, when they hate their own party, they switch and they go to the next party. And the same thing go on over and over. And it seems as if the same families could get the click. And the behemoth, I think, what is happening in the Bahamas, Howard, is the behemoth realize that time is limited for them to achieve their goals.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, they're coming out of school very poorly educated. Our average been de-average in this country, but I don't know how much different cycles of government.
Mm-hmm.
We keep saying we can improve education. We spend thousands of dollars on it, and the next BJC, GCE come out, same de-average. That doesn't change. The very few get to go to the University of Bahamas or off to tertiary education. When they come back, they can't get a good, decent job, what they expect, after spending the hundreds of thousands of dollars abroad. And when they come back from abroad, being trained by the abroad people, they want to say, we need to be Bahamian. How you could be Bahamian when you left your country to go to a foreign country to be trained by foreigners in their way of living? But how you could do your culture when you've been trained and to live another way? We understand also that our time is limited for us, male and female, man and wife, to attain their goal. Mm-hmm. Everybody see mm-hmm. the elites got their yacht parked out in the harbor. Their big homes in West Ridge and Old Port Bay, Vinton and Skyline Drive and San Susie. Everybody, I believe, want to attain those goals. But they realize the reality is the majority of us, if you get a government-built home in a government subdivision, you think you receive some there. And they call it a low-cost housing, and you end up 30, 40 years trying to pay back for a 10-year doggone mortgage mm-hmm. because you either lose your job, the cost of living go up higher, faster than your salary go up, the interest rates go up, and everything else goes down. And then how you expect people to stay away from crime where they got nowhere to go? They come out of school, they're looking for a job, maybe getting a job around a gas station at Wendy's.
Mm-hmm.
You know Bahamians ain't want weed in no yard, but they don't want no Haitian to weed the yard. But they ain't going to weed the yard because the fellow rather sit on the wall and drink Guinness and smoke ganja and push some drugs where he could make more money in 1 week than how you can make in a month.
Mm-hmm.
You understand what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Hello?
I read you.
We know the realities around here. You know, the young fella come out of school, and some fella get him into a gang, treat him good, pull him over with Nikes and pretty shades and a New York Yankees hat. So he cool. And he got one fancy little car with silver rims on it. So he feels like he reached the top of the ladder. And then he could push a half pound of grass or something in a week and make more than you and your wife together can make in a month. So we're encouraging him. And then he could find out one house on the road, he could buy this and buy that and get about 7 gold chain around his neck and pull up his mouth with gold teeth. We could turn him away from that. Nothing. We keep doing the same thing over and over. We keep getting controlled by foreigners. Our governments are controlled by foreigners. They come in here and they tell the governments what they want and what they're going to do. And they promise us a few jobs. You saw the video going around the other day. What does the black man own in this world when it comes to businessmen, businesses, and so forth? Name one hotel chain black man own. Name one airport, one airplane company a black man own. Name a range of banking institutions a black man own. But when the white man shows you all his yachts, the king shows you all his golden coaches and everything, where did they get them from? There's no known place in England where they got diamonds and rubies and gold. This is stuff they stole from black nations, from Mexican nations, from Peru, from Brazil, from all over the world. They stole it.
Okay.
They ride around it and show you off the stuff they stole, and they call themselves the powers of the world. When they reach the G8, the meetings of the G8, how many black nations
you see? So pull it together for me, Sparky. Pull it together for me. What you saying? How is that relating to what we're talking about locally? Talk to me about it.
When are we going to improve? When are we going to own anything, Howard? We're going to just go around in the same cycle. People don't start talking about the 2026
election. See, these are great conversations that we have leading up to election. But when we get in shooting range, when we get in arm's length of the election, all of this stuff is out the window. You know what enters the conversation then? You know what enters public discourse then? Well, I born FNM. I born PLP. I don't care if a dog run. I vote in this particular direction. And Sparky, you know that.
But okay. You know, one thing I want you to clear up to me. The FNM told me after the last election, right? They made this statement to me. Everybody knows Sparky's PLP. I grew up in the valley, and all my life I was a PLP. But I was never active. I would just go to vote, go back to work. But the last election, the FNM say they lost because their people didn't go out to vote. How do they know that the people who didn't go out to vote, because they said they count the registered voters and who went to vote, how do they know that the people who didn't go to vote was their people? If I didn't go to vote,
You ever worked the polls, Sparky? You ain't never worked the polls.
I never worked the polls. Okay. But how do you know your people? Your
I can
people,
explain it to you. I can explain it to you.
Sparky might have been the one who worked the polls. He goes to the polls by himself.
Sparky, I got to let you go. I got to let you go, Sparky.
He's going to vote by himself. How do you know if he's PLP or FNM and he's going there?
Sparky, I can explain it to you when we come back from the break. We got to be out of here. Thank you so much.
I'm coming in there with no red shade or no yellow shade.
You ain't got to come in there. We know who you is. Listen, Sparky, we know the landscape of everything. It don't matter if you're FNM or PLP. In fact, they learned this from the PLP.
My could be PLP, but my ex could be FNM.
Never. That don't happen like that, Sparky. Not in this country.
There's plenty of traitors in this country.
No. We can tell the traitors too. We know the shaky set.
Okay.
Judas, everybody knew Judas was going to be, oh yeah, it's probably Judas. Oh, it happened. So, if you don't know how the election is laid out, if you've never worked, and I keep telling people, you have to be involved in something. You have to understand the landscape of this thing. I got to take a commercial break, right? We got 3 minutes before we get out of here. We could go into the depth of this and talk about how you could identify you want.
I just want to just say, though, going back to what she was speaking about with Madam Komolafi, we all know.
Because I didn't get a call or a text for John. Good afternoon, Howard. This pulling down of Komolafi today is the plan of the devil. Agaro attended maybe one meeting. That's what he's saying about you. Maybe one meeting. How is it that he could speak about Komolafi in such a manner? Put a stop to it, Mr. Garth. It's the agenda of the devil today.
I wasn't putting a stop to anything. I'm not a part.
I want to talk about the Komolafi, you know. I just want to talk about.
But what I'm saying is that a sensible person knows that last time the PLP won the election, based on our trend, the FNM is slated to win the next general election. if you want to get into Parliament, whether it's you and your husband, you and your husband's country, you and the country of the Bahamas itself,
you're wilding out today, sir.
They, you know that I have to get on that ticket if this is where I want to be. And as you said, the crack in the foundation is so doggone wide and so doggone long that even blind man Bartimaeus in the Bible could see that if I want to get in on the next lap with all that's going on in the PLP today, I better jump on that F&M ticket. She sees an opportunity. She is not unwise for taking that opportunity. If you were her, if I were her, if anyone with any sense were her, we would say, you know what, I'm jumping on this ticket. And as you said, the lack of leadership simply says to me, I'm not going to be a backbencher when I join this party. I'm going to be in the forefront and, at worst, a cabinet minister.
Ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM Radio, Howard Grant and your company, The Foundation, on this Too Hot to Trot Tuesday. Obviously, it's wild and in full effect today. We're going to get into it on the next side of this. I see the phone lines are lit up. I wonder who that is. They're coming for you. I'm talking about people. Let's take this quick commercial break and be right back after this.
The Foundation. We'll be back right after this.
The Foundation. The Foundation.
At Marco's Pizza, we never skip on quality or ingredients. Save some cash and satisfy your cravings with our new carry-out medium two-topping pizza for only $12.50. That's right. Order two of your favorite toppings like sausage and green peppers on one medium pizza for only $12.50. Fat inclusive. On our app or online. Made daily with fresh dough, our signature sauce, and fresh cheese. Only at Marco's Pizza. Restrictions apply.
My Gateway is the centralized, safe, secure way to access and pay for government services online. Go to mygateway.gov.bs and log in to request a police character certificate, renew your passport or driver's license, and more. Receive emails confirming requests and alerts when documents are ready. You must have a valid government-issued ID in order to collect documents. My Gateway is fast, easy, and convenient. Go to mygateway.gov.bs and register today.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM, Nassau, Bahamas.
Foundation. Foundation. The Foundation. The Foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM Radio. Howard Grant, your company on this beautiful Tuesday, May 23rd, chopping it down with my good friends in the studio, Garth Roseboro, and none other than Bishop Kermit Ogaro-Hensey, being able to talk about a few things. Now, I just want to clear some things up, because I got some texts that make it seem as though we are identifying and strategically pulling down the character of individuals. I just wanted to talk about this charged political environment that the FNM seek to light a flame to, right? We know it's always kind of soaked in the proverbial diesel, even though it's not available today, right? We know that the environment, political environment, is soaked in this diesel, and it only takes a spark to get this kind of a fire running through the country. And we've seen that the Free National Movement has taken on this position to kind of light that spark. And I just wanted to know why they've done that, and more strategically and specifically, why the leadership of the Free National Movement through the person of Michael Pintard would identify such strength, right? If you're just looking for people is one thing, but you identify such strength and character and capability and articulation, and is she an understudy for? I don't know. And so I just wanted to kind of take it from that perspective and talk like that. But this is for Howard Grant. Not to pull this, and I'm hoping that this is for both of you gentlemen also. I don't want to pull down the character of an individual. I think it's very important that we understand these things. And there's a lot of social allegations propping up out there. But I really wanted to talk about these particular things. The DNA, in my view, is no more. Mm-hmm. I haven't heard anything from the DNA. And they have progressively, with every election cycle, done worse, mm-hmm. significantly, mm-hmm. than the last. They have done worse every single election cycle than the prior election cycle. And so there could be no expectation that they will even exist going forward. There's even more conversation than sort of a social buzz that flirting around and kind of surrounding the Coalition of Independence, right? The COI. But this concept and idea about the DNA is dead. And so I want to put it back on the table to you guys. I want to be able to talk about these things and then transition into something else. I want to talk about whether or not has this been a personal position that you've taken to talk about Arinthia and her leadership or capability, or do you believe that the qualities that she possesses being utilized in a strategic manner by the powers that be in these political organizations? Talk to me about it.
When she's definitely being used as a pawn, you've identified very clearly that she has the ability to be a queen.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever her personal objective is, we all have our personal objectives. She has an obligation to her husband. She has an obligation to her family. She has an obligation to her personal supporters. We're not going to deny that. We're not going to deny that she's a very articulate individual. She does carry herself as a lady, and we can respect that. But as you clearly showed us, Mr. Howard Grant, that this is not a person that you accept into your belly thinking that there's not going to be a sting. She is a leader, a female leader. She's an Amazonian leader.
Big time.
And so you must understand that with this whole battle of male versus female, they themselves accused me of hating female leadership. And I remember the time they had 2 days here at 96.9 saying that Dr. Hicks and I are not appreciative of female leaders, which was erroneous, very erroneous.
Was it 2 days?
I felt 2 days straight. I was slighted. I was home. I was fuming. No one gave me the opportunity to even defend myself, that very same entity. And they came after me full force. But I've always said to people, I respect the Harriet Tubmans of this world. My mother is a very strong woman. Anyone who knows my mother runs her house. And so, and I respect my mother to the hilt, even though I love my father. And so you have to understand that I don't dissect power in terms of male, female. But what I do know is someone's ambition. And Ms. Arinthia Komolafi is not just a person who's going to sit down in a pew and never attain the position of a pulpiteer. She's going to make it to that podium. And so for Mr. Michael Pintard to utilize her, thinking that she's a pawn to aggrandize himself and to make himself greater, he's playing a very dangerous game. Now, I'll say this to you.
He has
one safeguard against an Arinthia Komolafi coming to the party. There's no one else that shines greater than her right now in the FNM. But there is one who stands in the way, and that is the deputy leader right now, Mr. Shannon Dawn Cartwright.
You make me smile, sir.
She will go up against him.
Hey! This is heavy. What you doing?
I know. If she enters in and she goes up against and thinks to get to a Pintard,
she going up against who? He hasn't propelled himself anywhere other than being able to sit nestled in his position.
I love this conversation.
Huh?
I know,
as deputy leader.
I know Mr. Shannon Dawn Cartwright personally. I've worked with Mr. Shannon Dawn Cartwright on Paradise Island. I can tell you that Mr. Shannon Dawn Cartwright is not only articulate, he's a very sharp individual, and he's a number one salesperson. In the whole company of Atlantis, he sold millions upon millions of dollars of timeshare real estate. I know this gentleman's a bit. He can sell ice, not only to the Eskimos, but also to the Russians. He's good. But I'll say this to you. To me, in my personal estimate, Mr. Cartwright has been very passive, very non-effective. And I'll be very honest.
That's the 48 laws of power, sir.
Yes, he is just waiting for opportunity.
That's the 48 laws of power.
Because in his mind, he is one day going to be the prime minister of the Bahamas.
If Michael Pintard
falls, he is next in line.
He's
being able to watch the whole show. Now, if Mr. Komolafi believe that she's going to walk in there and assume that throne, she got another thing coming because the Chinese got a greater form of that thing than the Haitians got. Y'all ain't understand how the Chinese thing work. That Chinese thing work in the billions. They got billions of people in China when Haiti only got a couple million. So his thing, bigger than they thing. That's Miyagi.
What are you talking about, sir? What are you talking about?
I'm going to wash down and the wash up.
Are we going back to the old air conversation? You need to stop. Let me take it down.
I'm just using it proverbially.
But I'll tell you this. When I ran in Simbana was with the COI, Shannon O'Connor, me and him had a good relationship, good pet talk, and seems to be a good guy. And, you know, I support him. I support him 100% in Simbana was. Even though I run against him in the COI. He's a good guy, you know. We spoke briefly, And I made a declaration to him that I'm not going to run against him because, you know, he has a way of, you know, we cool.
Oh, this is the ice to the Russians and Eskimos thing.
Yeah, yeah.
You bought the ice.
Yeah, I bought
this
the
is ice. This is crazy. This is crazy, sir. I hope you have your receipt.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Let him know. Yeah. In due time, I buy the ice from you.
Okay, yeah, I'm not going to run against him. I'm just going to sit out and choose somebody else because, you know, I think he has some agenda. And some
sound like he can shoot and come out.
Yeah, and some he knows.
He's doing a lot.
He knows exactly what we discuss. And but he's a good guy.
Let me take a telephone call, ladies and gentlemen. 96.9 323 6232 325 4316 325-4259 anywhere from the family of violence 242-300-5720 or hit me up on the text 422-4796. Call on the line with us live. Go ahead. Go ahead, caller. Caller, are you with us? Next caller. Caller on the line with us live. Go ahead.
Hi, good day. How are you, sir?
I'm good. How you doing?
I'm good. So my name is Mr. Emmanuel Lambrista. I'm sure you're familiar with me.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So I just want to address a few things, Howard, what I've been listening to you and your guests on the show today.
Mm-hmm.
So my first point is, right, I'm sure you know Mistress Orinjia Komolafe's character.
Yes, I do.
And I'm not calling to even defend. And I'm not calling to speak on behalf of her, mm-hmm. because when she comes on your show, she can do that. Madam Komolafe is very competent and intelligent. But I will address three things in particular, though.
Let me hear it.
Number one, I hear you put in the atmosphere that Mrs. Komolafe is going to challenge or trying to come up against Pintat, Mr. Michael Pintat, the party leader of the FNM. That is absurd, Mr. Grant. Because if anybody knows Mrs. Komolafe, she respects leadership. Hand down. She believes in decency and she believes in order. That's just Mrs. Komolafe character.
Now hold on.
Hold on, Mr. Khan.
No, before you go forward, I didn't charge the atmosphere. We had to lay out a political strategy
And you said if Mr. Pinta doesn't watch out, X, Y, and Z in regards to Mrs. Komolafe.
No, this is the inevitability of what politics is.
Okay, but Mr. Grant, that is not Mrs. Komolafe's character.
Despite her character, she is a born leader. Do you
Everybody can be a born leader.
Do you dispute that?
She respects leadership, Mr. Grant. She respects leadership.
Do you dispute?
Then she joins the Democratic National Alliance. She went in as a candidate. After they lost the general election, the party members asked her to run for deputy leader.
Because they identify.
Can I referee something a minute?
I'm resting up, but I
told Howard you were going to call, you know, because I knew you were going to call. I already put my money on the table, and I won. Hold on, Emmanuel. This is Rose Power speaking. Mr. Emmanuel, we're not in the DNA right now. Give me 1 second, Mr. Emmanuel. Mr. Emmanuel, no, please.
Please,
no, I can't allow you to go to Howard. What Howard is saying to you, a leader does not elect themselves. Let me put this clear. Let's talk politics.
Hold on, Mr.
A leader does not, a leader never elects themselves. A leader wins by way of charisma. What you're simply saying to you is by way of her own charisma that she would be able to acclaim all of the support.
Go ahead. No, Mr. We can give you the opportunity. But I don't want you to kind of decipher what I clearly indicated. This was only political strategy laid out on the table.
But the political strategy is wrong, Howard.
How?
It
how can you say
when
that?
It comes to Komolafe.
Strategy.
She's not trying to go in there and take over the rest of the
we
party.
Didn't say she is.
Hold on. Let's be very clear. Hold on, Mr. Ambrister. Let's be very clear. There are rules and regulations that exist prior to us coming in this world. And when we leave, those rules and regulations exist in this space.
Howard,
this is what I'm saying to you.
I even understand
has
the political
nothing.
I understand the media. I understand when you put things out there, you see if it stick, let the person come. I understand all of these things, all of the rhetoric. I get that. I live by the game.
Okay.
So when people come out and start spooning it, I have to call you out on it.
Okay,
so
I see.
I'm going to go to my second point. Okay. I hear the young man said, oh, Mrs. Komolafe, husband is being involved in his meeting. First of all, this is a man who has his own career. A very successful career.
You call here and say that you're going to defend no one. And
No.
This
I said Mistress Komolafe. I'm now going to speak on something that the person said because I sit in every single meeting with Mistress Komolafe.
Okay.
Her husband do not be sitting in those meetings. So that's not true.
Mr. Ambrister, do me a favor. Because of your proximity to leadership in the former DNA, I ask you, like I ask many persons, can you reach out to your former leader and say to her, come sit on the show?
Howard, I don't
as
know the reason how we're going to come on your show.
As opposed.
Let us show and address these issues.
Okay.
So let's not need to sit up on these platforms and slap up attention, correct?
No, sir. And you know what? And I want to thank you for your telephone call. But if you're not going to have a conversation that has to do with the tradition of politics that exists in
Howard,
this culture and space.
It's not that, you know.
You're not being.
Because this guy have a problem with women leadership. That's just like a racist person saying they're not a racist.
So, but you're doing the exact same thing that you're saying that he's doing.
That's what I'm saying.
You're making these strong allegations and you don't
because
have anything to do
because that's what it is, Howard.
How that could be that and I was in the party.
I want to thank you so much for doing
man,
that.
Man, you're like, these people are dumb and stupid, man.
But no, don't do that.
I don't appreciate that, man.
Don't do that. Don't do that. They're too strong.
No, man, you can't be that ignorant, man. No, I am a Bahamian and you're bringing that out of me, man. Please don't do that, Mr. Bristol.
Let's be very clear.
Please don't do that to me. Don't put words in people's mouths, man. I don't like that.
People are impassioned about their leadership. They identify who they support and they will support them to the hilt, just like how you say you support your mother. We can't fight him for that.
This is a culture in this country, this is just the culture of politics.
I'm
not here to attack nobody's character, and that the what I've said has, you know, bearing to attack her character. I have no intentions to attack her character.
Let me take a next telephone call. Caller, you on the line with us live. Go ahead.
Good afternoon, gentlemen.
Hey, how you doing, my brother?
Fine, everything all right. Goth,
this you.
Goth.
You right here.
Yeah, calm down, man. God, calm down. This is my fault.
I only know I supported that party. I sacrificed for that party like everyone else, eh?
Yeah.
But listen to what I'm saying to you, sir. As Bahamians, when the hell are we gonna grow up and mature in this country beyond celebrityism in politics?
Exactly.
Oh, that's my MP. My MP Rich. If you just find out one MP who they thought was rich broke, they more broke than friggin' me.
So I'm hot mad now
because when you get caught up in people, and we're not getting caught up in the issues of this country. We got problems that we got to deal with, man. We got issues that we got to solve today, not tomorrow. And so when we get caught up in, it's Agaro. It's Howard. It's God. It ain't none of us. If it ain't God, well, to hell with it all, man. Let us all just burn, let the tsunami come, and wash us all away.
Okay,
Stop doing nonsense politically, and let's get this country right, man.
Yeah, well, every time you come on Howard's show, you know, you talk, or any other show, you talk plenty sense. And you're talking a lot of sense today. But, God, Orgy Dane is carrying on like how Perry Christie did. Orgy Dane is swimming in her own vomit.
Mm-hmm.
That's Orgy Dane.
That's heavy what you're doing. Yeah.
But use a strong DNA muff. Use my friend and my neighbor.
You know, God. I vote for Kamala.
So why are you saying that?
I always told Ms. Miskola I like her.
Twice. I like her strength.
So I know.
So I'm only saying to them, she's a very strong woman who will attract the support of many. That's all Howard is saying today, you know.
No, but guess like Leon Lundy do. Like I tell him, do he let me down? Guess like Kamala Fili let me down. They look like they so hard up to get in the House Assembly. But we can look at history and see that when you hard up to get in the House Assembly, like Randrick Wells them and Andre Wallace them, and then they don't make no sense when they get in their mind. When they leave this third party, when they talk bad with the FNM and PLP, call them everything except a child of God.
And then
join
them.
That's why I'm interested in politics. Let me go serve God and die. Yeah,
yeah, man. She let me down. So
thank you, my brother.
I ain't voting for the FNM or PLP no more. Because they got this country in the last 50 years. You want to see what happened? Man, the government was changing every 5 years for 25 years.
Mm-hmm.
Every 5 years for 25 years. That ain't telling you nothing. That ain't telling you them two parties the same. That ain't telling you that.
Wow.
Man, come on, man. Howard, you have an excellent show, man. Keep it up.
I appreciate
much
you,
respect,
man.
Right.
Thank
much
you
respect.
So much, man. It says that Bristol represents the fascism of Coma Laughing, and she encourages this as it has shown with the following form of the PLP to the DNA, back to the PLP and now to the FNM. No wonder why she never attracted the masses, seeming only those masses, the M is silence. Say the M is silent in masses. You all need to stop with your text, right? Let me see if I can take one more telephone call before we get a take a commercial break. Caller, you're on the line with us live. Go ahead.
Hey, good day, Howard.
Hey, my brother, what's happening with you?
Rachel, holding on. Poppy, your God. And to the next gentleman inside the God.
Yes, sir.
God got his head down. I think this is heavy for him. God, this is... God, you can be okay.
Yeah, man. I'm 54 this year. I don't need this.
Stay focused. People can say things sometimes. try to say what you're saying, and you know you ain't saying that, right? But the bottom line, like on
it's
the platform, about you there, you speaking to many of us. It ain't about you. It ain't about the person you're
talking
you.
To.
It's about the message
Thank
you're
you.
Bringing, you see? So a lot of us buy what you say earlier. You know? Now, I don't know if you have to come back, because I asked these questions with Howard to say, that he might be talking about, right?
Uh-huh.
Like how you say in the strategy and you observation or observe what's going on in the Freenas when you talk about Shenandoah Carteret and everything. This PLP government, you get a lot of PLPs right now. Like I say, you mightn't get the answer now. They saying, rather than saying this new day government, they saying this no good government. You understand? They say,
wow.
Like, I want to know what you think is the strategy for Brave Davis and the PLP leading in the next general election if God should spare our life. Like Jerome Fitzgerald, people like Fred Mitchell, how powerful these people is right now. Because to some of us, we feel like although we vote for Brave, or Brave may be the prime minister, these guys, them is like this, their government of Fred Mitchell, he's the prime minister, or Jerome Fitzgerald, who nobody voted for. I want to hear what your strategy, maybe you might have
the answer next time.
I know you ain't got to think about it, because you could see further ahead than many are.
You have always been wise. Man. You've always been
Thank
wise.
Thank you so much, man, Pop. I appreciate your telephone
You
call.
Have always been wise. Always been wise. And this is the Howard Grant Show, and I give all respect to Howard. Howard has never put anyone on the cross to crucify them. He just simply puts scenarios out there. He asks for opinions. He asks for truth. Tell me what's on your heart. If someone makes an observation, I just want to say this, Howard, as a leader, everyone is not going to agree with you. Everyone is not going to like you. Some people will call you sissy when you're straight, and when you're straight, they call you sissy. I mean, this is behemoth politics. Speaking to what you're speaking to, there's not one PLP or one FNM at this time. There are actually multiple heads or multiple personalities in each of these parties.
So these monsters.
So we have a old PLP, we have a new PLP. Mm-hmm. We have an old FNM, mm-hmm. we got a new FNM. Mm-hmm. And both of these entities are clashing within their very own parties. Everyone is seeking the position of leader to put their hands in the cookie jar. What we're seeing is that someone sent me a text this morning, the PLP is going to have a convention later this year to force the FNM to have a convention in February. What does that mean, Garth? I simply said that, listen, all of the allegations of convention, it's not wise for the PLP to have a convention at this time while they're in governance. What it's wise for them to do is to roll their sleeves and get to work. And much of these things that they've been promising us to start getting it done right away, because we have not seen sufficient enough for us to even want to warrant voting for them again. However, for the FNM, Mr. Pintaud has to do something extremely drastic to pull the front of the FNM together now. If he does not do that now, he is finished. And the Brave Davis administration will once again win the next election.
Brave Davis administration's sole objective under this umbrella that they've carried for a very long time, one party, one leader. The objective is to get in government. And based upon what I see, based upon the social acquisition, based upon identified persons and pulling them into the fold, based upon being able to ensure that they take care of certain people and send them off to places that they've never been and ensure that they're comfortable in these areas, they are on course with their internal objective. They've given us one objective, you know. They give us the blueprint for change, but they have another objective internally that says, we going to win this thing and break this cycle and break this curse.
So
and I think that they're on course.
And what they'll have to do, they'll have to show some type of extreme close friendship between a Deputy Prime Minister, Chester Cooper, and a leader in education, Minister of Education, Glenys Hannah-Martin. Here's where the divide takes place. We have the loyalists that are on both sides. We have some people who want to contest Brave Davis, but they're very weak. I think the Fred Mitchell fashion, they call it. It's a whole lot of controversy on the ground.
Already, I think that that's done.
Yeah.
Once that ship has sailed already.
So now we need Michael Pintaud to pull his ship together. Now, how can he do that? The question really and truly for this time is that...
But this is backward thinking.
We know it's backward.
This is politically backward.
This is Neanderthal thinking.
This is politically backward.
But for Pintaud to be strong, he has to deal with Minnis. Now, however he deals with Minnis is left to be seen.
Let's take a commercial break right there. Ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM Radio, Howard Grant, the Foundation. We're chopping it down today. Did not know we was going to get deep into this political conversation. Did not know that we're going to get deep into strategy. And let's not pretend that the strategy doesn't exist. Let's not pretend that we don't know the layout of the land. So what if the punch go on? There are other factions that do the exact same thing that the punch does. Y'all need to stop it and stop pretending that these things don't exist. Let's have a very clear conversation when we get back right here on the Foundation, 96.9 FM Radio. We'll be right back after this.
The Foundation. foundation.
The foundation. We'll be back right after this.
The foundation. The foundation.
Ready to step into the future? From your front door to the backyard and everywhere in between. See and speak to whoever's there with Ring Video doorbells and security cameras now available at Alive. Protect what matters most, all from one easy app. Available in your Google or Apple Play Store. Visit bealive.com/ring to learn more. We are Alive.
Make your morning sizzle with breakfast from Burger King Nassau. Enjoy not one, but two delicious sausage and cheese croissant sandwiches made just for you for only $5.75, including VAT. This breakfast classic is made with Burger King's savory sizzling sausage and melted American cheese on that classic buttery croissant you love. So say hello to sizzling mornings at Burger King with two sausage and cheese croissant sandwiches for only $5.75, including VAT. Only at Burger King Nassau, where taste is king.
Guardian Radio and the Foundation are on the move.
Bahamas, this one's for you.
SBT. Small Business Thursdays. Every Thursday, the Foundation with Howard Grant will highlight small businesses throughout the country, far and wide. Your products, services, prices, and personality. We want to hear it all. Get your 30 or 60 second advertisement heard on air at a fraction of the cost. We here at the Foundation understand the times and don't want you to be left behind. With Guardian Radio, you reach your specific demographic, and it is unmatched.
We reach thousands daily.
Get your products off the shelf and your services in their hearts. Small Business Thursdays with the Foundation, only on Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. For more information, call 302-2300 or the Help Me Howard line at 827-0111. SBT. Small Business Thursdays. Get your business moving today.
Foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, 96.9 FM radio, Howard Brown in your company, live and in full effect on this beautiful Tuesday afternoon, just talking, kind of shooting the breeze about politics. And, you know, I think the studio is significantly charged at this point. And I want to just be able to kind of put a disclaimer out there. This for Howard Grant and for my guests who stayed within the confines of what my expectations are for this particular show. This is not about the pulling down or tearing down of any one individual. I think everyone, I've led with a sort of a preamble of the expectation of what we can be able to see from leadership in Orinthia Komolafe. You can't hide leadership. Talk to me. Leadership can't be hide under a bushel. No. It can't be hidden under a rock. This is inevitable. It is pronounced. And just like Hubert Ingraham indicated, he said, well, you know, you don't tell yourself these things. You know, people just tell you these things because they identify the quality and the capability that you have in you. And even though it may be rough, dry in some areas, people call you into the fold and help you polish those areas to get to the inevitable position. And listen, whether you'd like to hear it or not, and I don't know whether or not Mr. Ambrosius should even, in my personal view, this is my humble opinion, he should have even taken on the position to be able to say that. Because these are politically astute men who know exactly what I'm saying. They know what I'm saying. This is political strategy 101. This is why you indicated that Shanadon Cartwright is sitting in a humble position.
Oh, yeah.
It's a 48 laws of leadership. Of power. The 48 laws of power. You have to stay humble in this position, but you retain this kind of a heaviness in your spirit. It is inevitable that you move to these particular positions. Inevitable. We heard the allegations, the stories, the ideas of certain persons trying to be able to shaft people within the organization, even as they climbed. Yes. You can't do nothing with these people because leadership rests heavy on their mantle. Talk to me. And Orinthia Komolafe is one of those people. Orinthia may be the first woman prime minister in this country. I just want to shoot straight. That may not be your business, may not be your position, but this is mine. If she remains consistent, persistent, humble, and presenting herself in this particular manner, she is going to eventually move to a position of leadership in this country. The world is changing. Our community is changing. And we identified this misogyny is being pushed aside. And people are embracing talents, qualities, articulation, strength, and vision. But this has to be polished. Don't fight me because I put the strategy on the table. This is only a political strategy. I won't be able to read a couple of these texts before we get out of here and do that. It says, personally, I think that Bahamians are fools if they don't vote COI. But given the trend, your cohort's logic is sound. This is what they're saying about you, right? It says that people say it's not the system, it is the people. But if you don't change the people that control the system, neither will change. No system of oppression could or would ever auto-correct itself without people forcing that change. This is a text that's coming through. It says, what happened to Dr. Sands? This is just a text. I think they accidentally text that, right? It says, anyone who goes into parliament and says that they don't aspire to be PM, this is what he says, should not be elected.
There you go. There's the truth. That is what you call truth.
Is it not first among equals?
Politics 101.
Are they not supposed to then all have aspirations of leadership from among the chosen of the first among equals? If Komolafe does not desire and aspire towards leadership in the Free National Movement, she should stand down. It's a text.
What somebody must have wrote that while I was sleeping, eh?
It's a text that came through.
That's powerful.
It's a text that came through.
You see,
and
true.
And what I wanted to say when you started your sort of discourse about the politics. No, before the tirade. Before the tirade. When you started your discourse about politics in the country, I wanted to really give commendation to the Free National Movement under the leadership of Hubert Alexander Ingram that afforded us this kind of a liberty on open airways to talk about some of the... Now, you know, it doesn't come without the social responsibility associated with it. And sometimes, and I'm hoping that those times have been significantly diluted, that we've seen victimization as a result of you taking on a position to speak like of that, course. Right? And I'm grateful even further than that for Guardian Radio to give us an opportunity to be able to have these kind of conversations very clearly. You could have your opinion, and I could have mine, and decency in order, and talk about these things. That is where we are going, and that is what needs to be celebrated in this year of our Jubilee. Let's be able to take a next telephone call. Calling on the line with us live, go ahead. Go ahead, calling on the line with us live. Caller on the line with us live, go ahead. Are you on with me, caller? Guys, 323-6232, 325-4316, 325-4259. Anywhere from the family of violence, 242-300-5720. Hit me at 422-4796.
Let me just say that those people who have attempted to bring a change to what we would call the major political parties in terms of forming their own party, I must give them some type of commendation, because it's not an easy thing to put yourself out there financially, to prepare yourself to be victimized in order to have a different voice. For those people who have entered into politics in the PLP, in the FNM, we did have in the past some very great people who did well for this country. Whenever you mention names like Frank Watson, I know this generation doesn't know the people like Frank Watson, Mother Cynthia Pratt, etc. I'm just calling in names, you know, Janet Bostwick, etc. The pioneering of politics in our country. I'm just calling out those few because they come first in my head. We are now looking for that type caliber of individuals
and character.
In today's politics and character. Someone said to me that in terms of female leadership, Glenys Hannah Martin is the last of the Mohicans. She is like just a great pan of pie for this nation.
I agree with
but
that.
When we look at the other female members of parliament, I don't think there's any one of them that can come anywhere near her performance.
Yeah, but when Glenys popped the gate, let's be decent. Let's be decent. When Glenys popped the gate, she's always telling the stories about being at the feet of her father and understanding that she had political leadership around her. She was propelled. It was inevitable for her to step in this position. So she came with a level of expertise that others didn't have. But also, she has garnered a great deal of expertise over the years in Parliament. So let's just be very clear. You can't compare the apples and oranges. And I can say to you, just like how Craig Flowers would have said to me, it'll be wrong of us to be able to give a contrast or identify yesterday with today and... reject the evolution of what has happened in the middle.
I would beg to differ only because the one thing that's been lacking in our political atmosphere is mentorship. If you know that she is great, rather than hating on her, whether she's PLP, whether she's FNM, the great people of politics, you as a member of parliament deserve to sit at their feet and eat and drink of their wine. But what we do when we get into politics is we become arrogant, we become selfish, we become greedy.
I don't know if that's entrance of politics. Arrogance is not something that automatically attaches itself to you like a virus. This grows in you as a part of your DNA. This is who you is. This is who you is.
You think they always was that way?
Yeah. You listen to me. So now we have
that disconnect where you talk about apples and oranges, because I can eat apple and orange in a fruit salad and enjoy the whole meal.
No, So
I'm simply saying to you, I agree with you.
There are medical terminologies that identify that you may have something, you may be predisposed to something, or it may be hereditary in your blood, right? But you don't see this when you're 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. But when you get 38, watch me. When you find yourself at an older age, these things just, I don't know why my knee doing like this. I don't know why my leg doing like this. Why this thing coming up on me? I got eczema and so forth and so on. This was always in your blood. That's how arrogance is. Arrogance exists in these particular persons. And it subsides and rejects and takes away from the leadership that people thought they saw in you. Because as soon as this arrogance pop up, they say, hold on. See, because there's a thin line between arrogance and confidence. And it's a thin line.
And that's why we can't see these members of parliament more than 5 years. After 5 years, you're gone. So what lesson is not being learned to teach you that if you got to fake it for doggone 5 years so you can get in for the next 5 years? Hold on, man. And then at least you can get 10 like a Rand with Wells. You see? But many people ain't getting it. Okay, I got to say this, man. Look at Mr. Miller in Golden Isles. He was in the FNM camp, yes? I sat in meetings with Vaughn Miller, PLP, on Step Street. I did that, side by side. But he ended in the FNM camp to get in. Once he got in, he switched to the PLP side. And what happened? He won again. Renwood Wells started in the PLP side and then switched over to the FNM side. And you saw him bowing down the minutes, like how the Children of Israel is bowing down to the golden image. So there's no loyalty in politics. And if you're going to be loyal to anyone, be loyal to yourself and be humble. Be a Shenandoah Cartwright and act humble even if you're not. That's all I'm simply saying. Learn the lessons of politics.
Let me take a telephone call. Calling you on the line with us live. Go ahead.
Howard.
Hey, how you doing?
I'm great. How are you?
Fantastic.
Who's the gentleman who's talking?
This is Mr. Garth Roseborough.
Garth Roseborough.
Yeah, that's him.
You are so right.
Mm-hmm.
I am so disappointed in Ms. Kumalafi. She is a political prostitute.
Mm-hmm.
And Howard, don't fool yourself. She ain't gonna be no female prime minister. I could tell you that.
I say she has the quality and capability of being so. I can't tell you what the future is.
She ain't gonna be no. She ain't gonna be no female prime minister. She hopping from body to body too much. Mm-hmm. And them Minister Penn died. No, she gonna take that position right from him.
Mm-hmm.
She gonna take that position because minister ain't gonna get it. That's my 5 cents on that.
I appreciate that. Thank you so much for your telephone call. Let me go to the next telephone call. Call you on the line with this live. Go ahead.
Howard Brown, how are you today?
Fantastic, my brother.
And your guests?
Hey, good afternoon.
Okay, Howard.
Yes, sir.
Let me give you a little history about politics.
Okay, let me hear it.
Ms. Kamalafi is a great person,
mm-hmm.
okay? Lincoln Main is okay. But listen, they have no stickability, okay? Check their track record as in politics. Continue to move from party to party and can't take your default, right? How you think they're going to stay in any party that they can't get their way? Hell no. And let me explain something to you guys right now. When you see the PLP machinery rolls out, see, like I was telling Lincoln Bain and those, they started campaigning too early. When the machinery of the PLP party, the Progressive Little Party, rolls out, they will be no more Howard. Trust me. Okay?
You know I know that.
Pardon me?
You know I know that.
Yes,
the PLP machinery, you play.
I keep telling person, they're talking about they want to change from being what we are now to a republic, right?
Mm-hmm.
How could you change from where we are now to be a republic if you're not speaking about it now while you're out of parliament? Mm-hmm. How is that going to happen, Howard?
Mm-hmm.
You can't wait till you get in parliament, then you talk about you want to change the landscape. Because guess what? You still gonna swear to the king, his successors, and his heirs. Am I right or wrong, Guy Howard?
Yeah, that's the truth.
Call you know, so if you're not educating the people of what system, republic system of governance, how is people gonna take to what you're trying to inject into their lives? That's not gonna happen, Howard.
Mm-hmm.
Have a nice day, man.
I appreciate your telephone call, my brother. Let me see if I can read a couple of these things here. I got some texts coming through. They load me down with it. So it says, Cartwright could never be PM or leader of the Free National Move. I have done politics for 40 years. Hardly ever wrong. They spell wrong. W-T-O-N-G. You know, it's oxymoronic when you say it. This is. Oh, I ain't trying to say you have never been wrong, but you're wrong now. No. Your text said that, so you could absolutely be wrong. If you give me a typo, you could be wrong about your analysis going forward, right? This is a text that's come through. So let's be able to read this. Very informative show, and your analysis is so correct. This is a text that's coming through, right? So let's see if we can read another one. It says, Howard, why are we wasting our time and our breath discussing the PLP and the FNM? If we can't see that the COI is the only party, I like this guy. He's so consistent and persistent, right? If we can't see that the COI is the only party making sense in this day and time, then we deserve everything that the PLP and the FNM does for us and the country in the coming years. Tell them legalize the thing, Howard. And when they want to be empowered, and when they want to be empowered, like your decent cousin Elliot. Guys, let me take this commercial break. 96.9 FM radio, guys. Let me take this commercial break and be right back after this.
Foundation. Almost there.
Sarge, that's you.
Well, who else?
Tell the truth. I thought a beige walrus was dying on the sidewalk.
I prepared for my 4x100 meter debut.
More like 1x1, because the other 99 killing you.
Funny, the Bahama schemes come in July 7th to July 15th, and Grandbahama gotta win this.
Well, you know that.
Email info at thebahamasgames.org or call 322-1029 for more information.
Which island is gonna win?
Tired of banks forcing you to use technology to bank the way they want you to? Your convenience is important. So no matter what your banking needs, Commonwealth Bank's friendly staff are always available in branch for that personal one-on-one service. But when you choose technology, our online and mobile banking app offers you state-of-the-art functionality. The choice is yours. Commonwealth Bank. Bank the way you want.
The road to 50 Jubilee celebration continues with the 50th On Bay Street Festival. Bahamian culture comes alive on Monday, May 29th from 2 p.m. until. Come out, bring the whole family to enjoy live music, food, drinks, cooking demos by local celebrity chefs, art, crafts, a kiddies corner, and so much more. It's Bahamian culture at its finest. The 50th On Bay Street Festival, this Whit Monday, May 29th. Bring the whole family, admissions free.
This is Guardian Radio, 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
Foundation.
And we are back, ladies and gentlemen, with a few minutes before we get out of here, 96.9 FM Radio. Howard Grant and your company on a hot, too hot to trot, tumultuous Tuesday. So happy to be in your company, guys, just chopping it down. Just for the purposes of those persons who are out there and don't understand, all this is a conversation about the landscape of politics in this country and whether or not the FNM is right in charging the environment, despite the fact that it'd be soaked and diesel, whether or not the FNM is right in being able to ignite this environment politically, and don't expect there to be a social kickback as it relates to this kind of conversation. This is what you expect. Did you not expect this? This is you looking for feedback. This is what this is. You already baited us with the pictures. Talk to me. This is what that was. You took the pictures, you baited us, then you came back and say that you expect Arinthia Komalafe to join the organization and she could speak to it, which blew my mind. How can she speak to these particular things and supersede all the constitutions within the Free National Movement? All this stuff blew my mind. So we're leading into this conversation. Why are you charging the political environment? Let me take a couple of these calls before we get out of here. Caller, you're on the line with us live. Go ahead. Caller, you're on the line live. Call you on the line with us live. Go ahead.
Hey, Howard.
Hey, my brother.
One more thing I forget. Do you remember the DNA slogan? PLT and FNM are two sides of the same coin?
Yes, I remember this.
So what interest would she bring to the FNM if the PLT and FNM are two sides of the same coin?
I don't know.
So what, she's going to eat her words now? Have a nice day, man.
I appreciate you. That's what the former caller said. You know, she's going back and swimming through her regurgitation. This is too much.
Either that or she's considering infiltration and trying to change from within, which is very difficult. But it's still a plausible theory.
That was the hope and expectation of why I joined the Free National Movement. That I looked at the layout. As you know, I was a part of the DNA. And in 2012, I ran in Central Grand Bahama and the DNA. I don't know if you knew that. Right? And there was a hope and expectation that this would be my party. That's why I joined the DNA, right?
I recall.
This would be my party.
I recall.
The FNM was my mother's party. The PLP was my grandparents' party.
Yes.
I need my own party.
Correct.
This would be my party, the DNA, right? And I committed myself, so forth and so on. And then as soon as things got a little rough, you know.
I recall.
They went contrary.
Because I had a conversation with you at the barbershop asking you to come back to the DNA when I myself looked inside to see what was going on. But I'll say this publicly to everyone. There are very few people that I've met, first time meeting them, that impressed me as brilliant, one that takes time to think things through, and one who is fair in analysis. And the reason why Mr. Howard Grant and I are friends is because we always have intelligent conversations. It's never about pulling down anyone. It's always about building this nation. I don't think we've ever had a conversation about women. We've never talked about girls and what men do to girls, and we've never talked about the haircuts that we got. We've never talked about cars or trucks or anything else other than the building of this nation. So I just want to applaud the listeners for tuning in to Howard Grant. He didn't ask me to do this, but I just want you to know that from his heart, he's all about building this nation. And we have to stop tearing down each other, especially the people who are trying to build the nation. I don't understand why many people continue to tear down the people who sacrificed to build it. The people who are stealing, I mean, I understand now. Give us Barabbas, eh? Give us Barabbas. We don't want Jesus. Give us Barabbas.
But, you know, the what I found in these last few minutes before we get out of here, what I found is that the sort of pushback I get is only because I could be able to break down your analysis, break down your approach, break down your strategy. I said that how dare you know this stuff, Howard? You could identify this. Why would you articulate this? This is supposed to be behind the cloak of secrecy. That's not what I'm doing here. I'm letting everybody know because it's time for us to be educated and understand the decisions that we make and how it affects us. Now, if after we've had relentless, inexhaustible conversations about where we need to go and who's thinking what and what could possibly happen and all the scenarios we lay out on the table, and you still decide to be able to get election fever, you know, because during the fever time, you can't see nothing. You inebriated all your everything.
Something
gone.
In that chicken.
Listen, all these things gone. Your equilibrium off, and you just make a decision. If you still walk into this election fever,
correct,
it cannot be as a result of the fourth estate not taking the time to show you that there is not empowerment here. There's no empowerment there, right? It cannot be because we didn't do our job in the fourth estate. It has to be because you've been socially conditioned, educated, and stuck in this position to accept what they give you, to accept what my granddaddy used to call hog slop.
Yes.
That's what this is.
Yes.
There is more, there is greater for all of us. And it's hard. I recognize that. My cousin called me last week and said, you are a hypocrite. I said, how I could be a hypocrite? I had a conversation about someone who's in the courts right now. Let's be decent about it. And I started to talk about this kind of an idea about our articulation in yesteryear, but when we move up to a position and finally be able to retain it, when we step over the threshold, we forget all these things. My cousin calls me and says that, you're a hypocrite. I said, well, how I could be a hypocrite? He said, in years to come, if you aspire to move towards leadership in this country, you're going to have to do the same thing. Blew my mind. Not what he said, but the reality of what he said. The sobering reality that we have accepted corruption in our politics. We have accepted corruption in this position.
Wow.
Blew my mind.
Wow.
that he says, I am a hypocrite. He put my hypocrite, the hypocrisy,
yes.
He put that in escrow. You understand? He put my hypocrisy in layaway. I am now chipping in as I move with aspirations towards politics, towards hypocrisy. It blew my mind that this is how we view politics in this country.
Well, you know what I said yesterday, and I'll let Bishop Garo have his closing remarks, but someone saw me yesterday, said, Goss, man, you ain't gonna never make it to Parliament, you know. I said, I can't. He says, why you can't make it? I said, because I ain't crooked enough. You know? So it almost looks as if that we continue to choose people who have a hidden agenda. Those that are pure in heart, those that really love this country, love the people of this country, really try to make their contribution. For some odd reason, people like you may never reach to the halls of Parliament, but this I will say to encourage you, continue to do it for God. If you cannot do it for yourself.
Well, I just want to say to the people, the beautiful people of the Bahamas, Bishop Kermit Agaro is not out there to assassinate nobody or to tear down anybody's character. I am a strategist. Anybody know me, I'm a saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost man. The Holy Spirit give me insights. And I just a strategy, and I could sit down and strategize and be able to understand people and their ideology and their concept and their precepts. So it's not to tear down anybody. It's just to uplift and to get up hammers and build a foundation that is on solid rock that we talk about. And, you know, I didn't want to elaborate on this, but I hope that the government of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas acknowledge entertainers. You got people like KB and all those other guys out there. You know, give them their props and encourage other young Bahamians to be able to pick up the gift and the talent, because the culture of the Bahamas comes through music. And music should be the greatest entity in this Commonwealth of the Bahamas, whether it's gospel or whether they are reggae or whatever it is that we call rake and scrape and all those good stuff. But I just want to say thank you, Howard, for allowing me to come on the show. It's a privilege and honor to be here and to speak, you know. And so I thank you. And I just want to say thank my parents and the beautiful people of the Andros. And I hope that we will fight for a factory, different factories in Andros, that we can employ thousands of Bahamians in the Commonwealth of the Bahamas.
I like this, my brother. I want to talk to you more about your factory. But it feels like I'm, you know... Would you just roll out before you decide to the manifesto? Sorry. let me read a couple more of these texts before I get it. It says, good day. Ms. Komolafe is a leader, whether she is actively seeking out leadership or she's elevated to a position of leadership. She will be the leader of the Free National Movement political party to the detriment of the Free National Movement. Pawns become queens. This is a text that's come through. So it says, we all know that to remove this cancer of corruption, we have to deal with and get rid of the sources. Neither of these parties are willing to do it. And the only hope for the Free National Movement was masterfully destroyed by Minnis' actions last administration. If Pintard was serious, he would have told us now what legal changes his party would be making, a.k.a. by an opposition leader. But as usual, it's vote for me, then I can fix it. But Minnis Dunn break down all that hope for the two to work again. That's a text that come through, right? So it says, Howard, the boat parties are fine. COI. Okay. This person's actually texting it. It says, Bahamians are not interested in capable competence, nor is the leaders of the political parties, major or minor. Isn't it amazing that persons like C. Allen Johnson and others who have described the world today are told us to prepare it years ago was never embraced? This text that's coming through. Ladies and gentlemen, I want to thank you so much, man, for being able to come in and join into the conversation and really chop it down with us. Like I tell you, this is your espresso. Listen, after two shots of espresso, I always get a little shaky. You understand? My hand already didn't get shit. This feels like three shots. This is mad shaky for me. Right? I'm excited. I'm charged up. And I think you all know, who've been listening and watching me over the years, that this is what I truly enjoy, to talk about leadership, to identify who I believe has the qualities and really put it on the table, right? With transparency to talk about these things and break it down. Garth, my brother, I thank you so very kindly. Bishop, I want to thank you for being able to join us today. Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for being a part of this conversation. I have Cassius Stewart in. I'm sure he's going to tell us a great deal about what the B is for in Bahamians. You say, the B in Bahamian is for big man. So I don't know. I'd be definitely going to be able to talk about that tomorrow.
I thought he was talking about the LGBT.
He can talk about some stuff tomorrow, guys. I want to thank you all so very kindly, guys. Enjoy the rest of your Tuesday. Have a beautiful time. Be safe. Be responsible. Join us here again tomorrow on the Foundation from 12 to 2. And thank you. If you want to be a part of that and participate, 8270111, 8270111. We got a great deal of things coming up. I want you to be a part of that. We're headed to Grand Bahama from the 5th of June to the 9th. Be a part of that, guys. Stick and stay for Z.